You want to grow your muscle? Take creatine. You want to run faster? Take creatine. If you have nothing else to do, take creatine. Creatine is one of the most famous and researched nutrients in sports and exercise, especially for muscle gain. So, should we take creatine supplements for our exercise? Our body naturally produces the amino acid creatine, about 1 gram a day. Though you can get additional creatine from foods such as red meat and seafoods like salmon and from the supplements. Usually, taking 3 grams of creatine a day for 28 days is optimal during exercise to increase your performance. So this is your muscle, and if you zoom it in, you can see the muscle fibers which need energy called ATP to contract and perform work. But very little ATP is present in the muscles, so that the muscle can work only for a few seconds with this stored energy. In the body, creatine is converted into creatine phosphate, and this creatine phosphate replenishes the ATP of the muscle so that the muscle can now work efficiently for a longer period. So creatine provides energy for the skeletal muscle. Creatine also increases cell hydration, which draws water into the muscle cell, increasing the muscle mass. So you might notice an increase in your body weight under creatine supplementation. It also reduces muscle breakdown. So overall, creatine increases the muscle mass and reduces muscle fatigue. The brain also uses energy from the creatine phosphate, and recent studies found that a key factor in several neurological diseases is a reduction of phosphocreatine in the brain. So body's creatine maintains a good mental health, but further research is needed for this relation with creatine supplementation. Side effects of creatine? Yeah, but not very much. First of all, creatine is not a steroid. Taking high doses of creatine, as in so-called loading phase, during heavy lifting might lead to dehydration because of the muscle's hydration and longer workout sessions. And it might cause digestive disturbances in some people, even though it is not scientifically proven. When creatine and creatine phosphate are used up by the muscle, they are constantly converted into a compound called creatinine. Blood creatinine levels are usually a good indicator for kidney health, as it is the responsibility of the kidneys to excrete them in the urine. So high levels of creatinine in the blood might indicate impaired kidney function, except when there is some muscle abnormalities. Creatine is considered to be safe, at least for most people. You can find many different forms of creatine, but the most famous one is creatine monohydrate. So I care about you, but I don't know about you. So if you have any underlying conditions, such as in the kidney, heart, digestive, or literally any other problems, consult with your doctor or nutritionist about taking creatine supplements. Now you have the knowledge about creatine. So do you spend a lot of time watching your phone or laptop like me? Then you might have digital eye strain. So here's my experience with a digital eye problem, from tips and symptoms to causes. Stay safe and stay healthy. See you in the next video.